Tocando sua xere. Hey guys,
welcome back. Gonna do a part two of his Sorcerers Saga by K-Rino. This one's Annihilation of the Evil Machine. Once again, I've got the lyric video, you know, so I don't miss any stuff. Storytelling mode again. Let's jump onto it, man. Sounds very militant.
Existed. The war between the sadistic and the realistic had been predicted. Yeah. The balance of the world's power shifted when artistic control was given to the wicked and lifted from the gifted. When I...
Is he talking about the alien baby story that we did yesterday? Now he's saying years before I was born, you know, there were a fucking war. Yeah, and the gift, what did he say? He said the gift control were given to the wicked and lifted from the gifted. So if we came, that book were lifted, stolen, you know, from the king, there by the wicked K guy, who we thought were KL, who I thought were KL, Superman, obviously not Superman. I also thought it was K-Rino, but I'm kind of thinking it's not now.
Shifted when artistic control was given to the wicked and lifted from the gifted. When I was born a female mystic, insisted she entered the room, leaned over my forehead and kissed it. Inside me, my assignments were listed. I was never told this till I was older, fearing the risk that I resisted. The first con-
is he like some, you know, some like chosen guy? Fucking some messiah. It's not messiah, but you know what I mean. Born, fucking old woman comes over, kiss him on the head. So, you know, you've got some shit to do when you're older, man. Got some shit to do. Is it? I might be jumping to conclusions a minute in, but I'm thinking that the alien baby, this is what I'm thinking already. Alien baby dude landed on Earth. Now they need someone to stop the alien baby dude, which could be K-Rino when he was born. He's now got all this shit, you know, your future's planned out. This is what you're going to do when you're older. You're going to save the planet. From evil baby dude. Maybe. Mine's working overtime. I like stories.
Till I was older, fearing the risk that I resisted. The first composition I ever composed triggered a conscious thought probe that the mystic had enclosed. I folded in an agonizing pose. When it was over, I would hold the keys to expose the motives of the soul. Meanwhile, on the same side of the globe, a slow-growing entity drove the masses to ignorance overload. I stayed inside my reclusive mode, and although this was strange, I still didn't complain, though I blatantly noticed the change.
So, what I'm getting is, you know, K-Rino didn't realize he had this gift inside him, or whoever he's talking about, didn't realize he had this gift. Start composing music, or composing, you know, doing the shit that he does, yeah, and it awakened the thoughts inside him. Yeah, so now he knows a bit of stuff now, you know, he knows what he's here to do, and he's noticed that other side of the world, maybe in South Park, with Ken and Kenny and the rest of them, you know, fucking Mr. Hankey and that shit, but this dude's landed there, and he said, oh, I know something's stirring up, maybe not.
Didn't complain, though I blatantly noticed the change. I started having recollections, nostalgic reflections of things that ignited mental resurrection. Now every audio visual object we digest contributes to this gradual degenerative process. Nonetheless, I wasn't under stress, I just rested and convalesced. Sharpened my talents to soar beyond the best. Fell asleep and felt like something was being put on my head. I woke up and saw two individuals at the foot of my bed. One said,
it's like that two sides to a story. He's getting abducted. So yeah, it's kind of took me off what I was thinking then, you know, because you know, we talk about audio, visual, and it's kind of made me think, you know, about how life is now compared to how life was when I was younger. I'm only 34, but when I was younger, we were never, ever in the house. Yeah, always out with your mates. Time to come home, when streetlights came on, you heard your mum shouting, you say, oh, can I have 10, 15 more minutes? Nowadays, there's no kids out on the streets. All they do, I've got three kids, 15, 8, and 3. And all three of them, especially the oldest, she's got the newest iPhone Pro Max, whatever it is. Yeah, and my daughter, my middle daughter, she's got, the new Amazon Fire tablet, whichever the newest one is, got it for Christmas. Yeah, my little lad, he just wants to play on people's phones all the time. So, you talk about the audio visual stuff. It's kind of like technology's taking over people's lives. Do you know what I mean? We try and limit the time they have on them, but sometimes it's too easy to say, if you're doing something around the house, and you try to get something done, say, oh, Dad, can I have your phone? Yeah, just check it. Just while I'm doing this. It's too easy to say that now, But when I was younger, you never, ever, ever would leave the house. Never. But now, you never see kids outside. They're always in, playing computers, playing on the phones. Probably has nothing to do with this story that he's telling, but I just thought I'd get it off my chest.
And saw two individuals at the foot of my bed. One said, listen, K-Rino, you've been chosen to fight the deadly force that germinated and rose in the night. All the knowledge that you'll need, I'll expose on this flight. What's up with this paralysis? You're frozen in light. Where can you?
What's up with this paralysis? You're frozen in light. Paralysis is where you can't move. You're frozen in light. The light could be like the knowledge. You're frozen in the knowledge that's shining on you. Anyway, he's been picked for this fight. I might have been right at the beginning. He's been picked for this fight against the dude that's germinated. Called him germinated. Who uses the word germinated? Like, germinated. I'm going to use that today on someone. He germinated around my area for.
What's up with this paralysis? You're frozen in light. Where can you unfreeze me? And please be quick about telling me the reason why you come to seize me. He said, I'm sure you heard of the machine where we convene concerning its destruction, and we've chosen you to lead the team. Folks are going to die. You have no choice, so you better comply. I said, I was no one special. I'm just a regular guy. He said, that's a lie. You were born for this. Never deny. I looked in his eyes and said, okay, man, whatever, I'll try.
So you're getting told, you're Earth's last chance. Yeah, whatever, man. I'll try. If someone came up to me and said, you're born to lead the Earth against this evil machine, and you're the last hope, I don't think my words will be, yeah, whatever, man, I'll try. You said something else in there that kind of made me laugh. Oh yeah, so there I said, folks are gonna die, so you've got no choice, so you better comply. So that's, to me, that's kind of an oxymoron. So saying you've got no choice, so you had better comply. It should be like, you've got no choice, so you have to comply. If you've got no choice, then you've got no choice. You can't say no, if you know what I mean.
That's a lie. You were born for this. Never deny. I looked in his eyes and said, okay, man, whatever, I'll try. 2 seconds later, I went from my room to on the craft. Inside the lab where I received training to run the staff. What seemed like one day of training had been a year. The mystic reappeared and said, no one must interfere. I said, lady, I could be wrong, but I feel like I know you. She smiled and said, you do, and at the proper time, I'll show you. As for the masses, there's a fate you have to save them from. Look at the people and how disillusioned they become.
So, time flies when you're having fun. It felt like the training was just a day, but it was a year. I say year. My wife says year. Anyway, enough of that. So he's done his year's worth of training. Yeah, this mystic's turned back up. He's like, I sort of know you from somewhere. Yeah, but obviously he doesn't know because he was a baby at the time, but something deep down inside knows who she is, can't speak, knows who she is from what happened when he was born. you know, deep down inside him. Shit's about to go down. Sounds to me like there's going to be a war. Look how disillusioned these people have become. Look at the people and how disillusioned they become. The thought streams that this machine is filtering are ill-meaning and bewildering. You have to kill this thing. The thought streams. So like if you think of a computer, yeah, I like that. It has streams of information. So this machine, is it literally a machine? Like a robot? I thought it would be ever. That was just like a backstory for K-Rino and the evil baby story with the alien baby story was the backstory for the alien. And this K-Rino, this is a backstory for K-Rino. You know, and then do they eventually fight each other? I think I'm just jumping to conclusions because I don't know why I'm jumping to conclusions. Ill-meaning and bewildering. You have to kill this thing. You have to start with all of its compartments and execute mark hits on targets from Earth or orbit. After I listened, I started on my mission with one magician from the spacecraft as my assistant. The first place he brung me, it stunned me. What I saw living among me, 85% were already zombies. The schools and the streets and the houses were doused with the venom of lying governments and sick media outlets. All intelligent thoughts that sprout get rerouted and ousted. I had to obliterate the whole outfit. I'm not sure whether I'm right. I'm kind of confused. I think I've confused myself. You know, because he said, look at all these zombies in school, all these zombies in the houses, all these zombies in the streets. You know, and it's what? I don't know what the evil machine is. Is the evil machine like the government? Or is it literally a machine? You see, you've got to get all these different compartments. Anyway, he's got a magician with him. Magician. I had to obliterate the whole outfit, but where was the station? We tried to pinpoint its location with extrasensory perceptive navigation. 2 seconds after springing to action, I saw on the caption the giant shadow of a robotic contraption. I turned around. It's a robot. So I'm kind of thinking, yeah, that the whole thing's about information. Yeah, So you get fed shit from the media, you know, you turn your computer on, you turn your TV on, you're always getting fed this information. In schools, you're educated what they want you to be educated in. If you get what I'm saying, is this what he's getting at? Like you're not literal zombies, but you're zombies to what you get fed into. Not like, you know, I'm not saying that everybody's a sheep, but 100 people go to class and get taught about, I don't know, about the history of, I'll just say World War II, yeah? 100 people go to class and get taught about World War II. Yeah, and the 100 people know the stuff that they get told about World War II. But other stuff might have happened that you don't get taught, so you're always led to believe what you get taught is true, and you know, might leave some truths out or some shit like that. I'm not saying that that's what happens. I'm just taking World War II as an example because when I grew up, we had to do a lot of stuff in history about World War II because obviously I'm from England, you know. So you only know what you get taught, basically. So, or what you get led to believe. I'm talking some shit now. On the caption, the giant shadow of a robotic contraption. I turned around and shockingly seen a technologically supreme object that no logic could possibly dream. Everything that it said was obscene, plus his head was a screen. It blasted at me with a red glowing beam. I blasted back with a shot of my own. Medulla oblongata, lava fire straight out of my bottomless dome. I heard a voice that made my hair raise. To paraphrase, it said, we'll forever convey our wicked ways over the airways. We can't stop the rise. So this it's sort of like the Matrix. Do you know how the Matrix, not the Matrix, but the real world of the Matrix, you know, is all fucking machines. You know, they tried to blow up the machines, didn't they? You know, in the film The Matrix, they tried to blow up the machines, they burnt the skies, then everybody were plugged into a fucking computer. Yeah, but, you know, when Neo gets out, you know, they're all on spaceships and stuff, and they all try and kill these machines. It's kind of like that in my head. This is like a whole film going on right now as I'm listening. It's like a blockbuster going on. So it's this machine. I just feeding it information that it wants you to know, that it wants you to believe. You know, it's coming over the airwaves. You know, but now because K-Rino has been taught, been had his eyes open to what's actually going on, like Neo did in The Matrix. Yeah, he can do some fucking death-defying shit. Yeah, and put a stop to it. Kind of. Airwaves, we can't stop the rise. We were put here to deceive the wise. We're the ones who say the truth and make people believe the lies. Made the world slave, so don't defy it. To save it, I would try it. It was modern day David and Goliath. This denial den that we resided in was multiplying. This Leviathan was like trying to escape the Poseidon. So every great phrase that was ever spoken, I quoted, decoded, and overloaded his modem till it exploded. He's blowing it up with knowledge. Every great phrase that would ever spoken, I re-quoted it. So he's overloading it with knowledge, blowing its modem up. Because this machine's so big, it's a modern-day David and Goliath. But this machine, obviously, all machines taking information, and it's taking in too much information because of every great phrase that was ever spoken. He quoted, it was like a Leviathan, which is like Leviathan, like a demon. They were on supernatural ones, weren't it? Leviathans. Yeah. It was like trying to escape Poseidon. Obviously, Poseidon, boat turned upside down. People tried to get out of it. Never spoken, I quoted, decoded, and overloaded his modem till it exploded. When it blew up, I was glad and released it. Then I seen new machines forming from each of the fragmented pieces. Now I gotta overcome the offspring, the children of them. I went from dealing with just one to a million of them. So this machine, this freaking massive craft has blown up million pieces. Now these million pieces have took on a mind of their own. Yeah, it's sort of, it seems like a fucking million films in one. So you sort of think of like Terminator 2, for example. You know, that T-100 or whatever it was called, or T-300. You know, the dude that fucking can liquidize himself, when he gets blown up, his little bits fucking take on a mind of themselves and, you know, go back together. This shit needs to have a music video. I went from dealing with just one to a million of them. A whole army in the distance ahead. And prisoners of listeners tapped my assistant and said, I need a G719 skill gun. He said, I never heard of that. I said, I know, I just made it up. Go build one. He left and said, okay. What the fuck? I need a G719 fucking kill gun, however he said. What? What was it? A kill gun? Skill gun. I need a G719 fucking skill gun. Genesis. Has he gone religious? G719 skill gun. G719. Is 2 seconds. Right, I'm back. I thought that had something to do with religion, but it turns out that G719 is from Book of Genesis. 719, the paragraph 719 means that the hills and stuff are overrun with water. Yeah. I don't know why I came to the conclusion that it was religious, but G719 sounds familiar. So anyway, so now he's overrun like a river of fucking machines. So he needs a skill gun, the G719 skill gun, to wipe them out. And machines cannot be put in water. I think I've read too much into this.
A 19 skill gun. He said, I've never heard of that. I said, I know, I just made it up. Go build one.
Never heard of that. Fuck it, just go build one, man.
He left and said, okay, I go get it. Just hold him off for a minute. 60 seconds later, he reappeared with it. I snatched it with no time to study or test it. It consisted of just one definite button, so I pressed it. Smoke. I saw people, one of them stepped out of the crowd and spoke. It's so enlightening to be mentally redeemed, he said. I'm like, what happened? He said, look, all the machines are dead. Conscious thinking that the ultimate degree again. No more government, commercial radio, or CNN. The gas released out of your weapon made the cameras fall. Reverse the spell of the machine and deprogrammed us all.
Gas, it weren't water. I don't know where I got that G719 from. I really don't know where that came from. But anyway, you know, this dude said, it don't matter if you've never heard of it before, just go get that skill gun, that G719 skill gun. It only took him 60 seconds to make it. Turned up, 60 seconds later, boom, shot it. Only had one press at the button, boom, blew everything up. You know, it looks like it's raining here now, but there are a cloud of smoke, machines are dead, people have been lifted or deprogrammed from how they used to be. It's like the eyes have been opened. Yeah, there's no more, what they say, there's no more media, there's no more government commercial radio, that shit feed that you feed off, or CNN. It's obviously got something against CNN. CNN's not in England, so I don't really know much about it. Yeah, but the gas made all the cameras fall, reversed the spell of the machine, it fucking enlightened everyone. Got rid of the grip that this machine's got over everybody, the hold that this machine's got over everybody.
No more government, commercial radio, or CNN. The gas released out of your weapon made the cameras fall. Reverse the spell of the machine and deprogrammed us all. I said, but there were millions, how could we persist to live? After the wisdom, everyone took the initiative. One by one, they were individually destroyed by everything with knowledge, all functions deployed. They sparked the process with cerebral brainwashing, narcotics, scientific control, anatomic robotics, melodic hypnotics. The mystic being delivered my fate, waved and erased my memories, sending me back to my original state. You wonder how then was it told of y'all? The thought probe was never taken out. It recorded the whole battle and showed it all. Now future generations can say that they seen the total annihilation of the evil machine.
So, you know, the mystics fucking sent him back to how he were before, you know, and erased it. So the Earth's gone back to how it should have been, you know, before the evil machines became where they were. So K-Rino's there again, ready to fight when called upon against the evil baby. Anyway, guys, that's that one done. I probably thought far too deeply into this. I've fucking probably ruined everybody's day by doing this video, but it's done now. Can't take it back unless you use a G17 skill gun. Yeah. Right, guys, that's that one done. Hope you have a good day. Thanks for watching if you watched till the end. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks for watching.